Morning, this is Dr. Luis Feitoza, and I will be demonstrating lung ultrasound and probe placement on bovine. It's around 800 pounds, 850 pounds. We're gonna be using the IQ Plus Vet. First, again, we have to be safe with the chute, so we wanna keep your hands out of any place that might hurt you, okay? Most of the chutes those days, they have drop downs on the sides just to make it safer and easy for you to access. All right, so I will put these down. Depending on how big the animal is and how forward the animal is caught on the head gate, you might not have to drop those two down. You can probably just do it with one down. For the video, because it's easier for you to see the whole side of the animal, I'm dropping those two sides down. For contact, I will be using alcohol. You can also use gel, or you can use mineral oil or a combination of these. I like to use alcohol. It's my personal preference. It's fairly inexpensive and it's pretty straightforward. I can have in a pump like this and I can just spray it, okay? Lungs on an animal, on a bovine, the lungs are quite pointy up here, okay? This is the caudal dorsal area. So we palpate the last rib, which is the 13th rib, and we want to be scanning every single intercostal space from the caudal area here all the way to the 9th or 8th intercostal space, okay? So you can just scan it. You palpate and you place your probe on the last intercostal space. Make sure you have plenty of contact. Your worst enemy is on the ultrasound is having a bad contact. So you want to be able to decrease as much air as possible between the probe and the skin of the animal, okay? So you palpate and you feel the last intercostal space. Make sure your cranial indicator is pointing up. And then you go dorsally, ventrally. It is important also to, if you're caudal here, that and that varies animal to animal. If the animal has a pretty distended rumen, things gonna be pushed a little bit cranially, a little bit forward. So you might have to skip to the next intercostal space. And again, dorsally, ventrally. Make sure you're giving enough time for at least one or two respiratory movements so you can see pleural sliding. You can see if there's any B lines present there. Again, B lines are an indicator of lung injury. And B lines are those lines that go vertically from the top of the pleural line all the way down to the image, okay? They look like high beams from a car in a dark road. They just start really thin at the top and they widen out at the bottom of the image. So you go intercostal space and you scan all the way down. Make sure you're fanning your probe. So fanning is you changing the angle of your probe. So with that, you get to see more of the lung tissue. So you go down and fan. Make sure you're always fanning as you go down. The more you do this, you get a little bit faster on identifying artifacts. But it's pretty simple. You can score animals through score 1 through 5, 1 being healthy, 2 having thin and less frequent B lines. 3 having more B lines and merged B lines, meaning that you have so many B lines on that image that they start to merge and become really wide B lines. 4 is you have low degree of consolidation, B lines combined with B lines, and 5 being that lung is totally consolidated. It looks almost like a liver tissue, which we call hepatization. When you get to the score 5, which is the highest score, that area of the lung no matter what you give to that animal, that tissue is not recovering anymore. So it's very important to be able to differentiate those scores, because that gives you ability to create a prognosis and also a treatment protocol. So other important thing is you can do that on the left, on the right side, either or. Okay, on this case, we're doing the left side on the caudal dorsal area here, but you can do on the right side too. It's what is the most accessible for you. The research that we have done, we collected the data on the right side of the animal for a couple reasons. One reason is that most of the operations, especially on feedlots, all the computers and everything, the drugs and all the features and the tools that we're going to be using going to be on the left side of the chute. Just by convention, most of the feedlots are like that. So for us not to be in a way and things like that, the data was collected on the right side. But it's important to say that you can do the ultrasound in either or, okay? Left or right side. There are some research published on scientific journals that on the right lung, you're on the cranial ventral side here, down here, you're gonna be more likely to find respiratory disease because the way the trachea goes down and splits its way to the right and the left side, it does a little bit cranially, more cranially than on the left lung. So when we have a bacteria infection, so it's heavy and dense, it usually goes to the right side first. So you might be more likely to see lung lesions on the right side than on the left side, but you can scan either or, left or right side. So I will start again on the tip caudal dorsal area, and I will go dorsal ventrally towards the head. Okay, so I will just go this way every intercostal space. All right. So hit record. So there we can see air. So we're too far back. So we want to go one intercostal space over. And the more you do this, it gets easier as you go. If you're having difficulties to find the correct acoustic window, you might want to put the probe sideways or perpendicular to the ribs. When you do it that way, you can see that you're gonna have a rib shadow in both sides of the image, especially in smaller animals. Because of the footprint of the probe, and that is called a bad sign. When you centralize the image of interest in the middle of the screen, then you can rotate the probe and have a full screen when you have it parallel to the intercostal space here. So on this image, we can see several A lines here all the way through the image, which indicates that you have a healthy piece there. There are some incomplete B lines or I lines. So we see on the top of the image, there are some little beams that go down. Those are not B lines, those are called I lines because they're not complete. Okay. His lungs look all right. There are few B lines. The ones that we can see, they are very thin, and there are very few of them. So that's not concerning. The other thing that we can evaluate with the lung ultrasound is pleural effusion. So when we look at the pleural line, which is that bright, the first bright line on the top of the image, if we have a very dark space in between the pleuras, that indicates that we have liquid there. So that's called pleural effusion, and that's one thing that you should be looking at. And it's pretty obvious when it's there, because that it's one more thing that can give you valuable information for prognosis, right? When the animal has a bunch of liquid around their lungs, the lungs cannot expand the way they should expand. So when you have effusion, that case is a little bit more complicated compared to a case without effusion, okay? So with the IQ plus VET, we're able to look at the lungs, no problem. With this probe, the footprint, it's great to fit right in between the ribs. Even with the big, small animals, I was able to scan it, no problem, in between the ribs here. And just the ability of using the iPad or iPhone. I like to use the iPad because I like a bigger image, but that's just a personal preference. I have scanned with my cell phone as well, and I never had problem with it. If you have any questions, you can reach out to our team and we can help you out on how to perform the lung ultrasound and how to evaluate it. If you have any problem, if you have any question, feel free to contact us and we'll be happy to help.